Good morning, everybody. How are you doing? Is everybody okay? All right, it's time to do the last grammar topic of our Unit 8. Remember that in our Unit 8 we are talking about news, yes? And when we talk about news, we have already studied that they didn't respect the grammar. Yes, they take out some words. They don't use the verbs in the past, for example. They didn't use articles, possessives. And now it's time to study a different form of reported speech. Do you remember reported speech? Renata said, we have studied the grammar before. This is reported speech. Yes? Okay. So we are going to study the reported speech again, but with some different information. When you study the reported speech before, you always have to change the tense of the verb. For example, I am working, Renata said she was working. I traveled to Japan, Renata said she had traveled to Japan. Yes, we always put the verb in a tense back. Ok? Sempre colocávamos o verbo no passado. Yes? Ok. But now it's going to be different. When the verb we use to report is in the present, we don't need to write the verb in the past. Okay? People have many rights. He said that young people have many rights. Can you see that our verb in here, it is in the present? So when our report verb is in the present, you don't need to change the verb tense. Okay? All right, so when the verb here, the report verb is in the present, you don't need to write the original sentences using the verb in the past or past perfect. Past continuous. When the information reported is a general fact or is still true or correct, you can choose if you prefer to use the sentence in the present or if you prefer to use it in the past. You decide, okay? Okay, I'm going to use the. I will say these sentences using the verbs in the present form. Good. I prefer to say these sentences using the verb in the past. So you can say here, first said that the earth was round. Okay? She asked me why I didn't speak German. Okay? So you decide if you prefer to use the verb in the original form, according to the sentence that was said, or if you prefer to change it to the past. Okay? It's optional. With certain structure, particular modal verbs used to and conditionals. So when we have reported speech with modal verbs, we are going to keep them as the same one. So if the original sentence is, guys, you should study. The teacher said we should study. I didn't change the modal verb. Okay? You have to pay attention. The teacher said we have to pay attention. Okay? The only one that is going to change is this. Can is always, could. Okay, when our sentence is with can, we need to change the can and write could. Okay? We change time and location expressions if they are different from the original conversation. Sometimes we have to add more information. Okay? Yesterday, we did the review of the vocabulary review. Okay, yesterday we did the vocabulary review. The teacher said she has done the vocabulary review yesterday? No, the day before. Okay? So when we are writing reported speech, we need to change the time expression. Okay? Can you see here? My flight is at 6 a.m. Michael said his flight was at 6 a.m. on Tuesday. Teacher, but here is present and the verb is in the past. Why? You said that we don't change the verb, que a gente não precisa voltar o verbo no passado. Sim, nós não precisamos trocar o verbo se o reported verb estiver no presente. Reparem aqui que é said. Então, eu tenho que colocar passado. Aqui em cima, olha lá. Says, present. O verbo está no presente. Tells, not told. Ok? I will meet you here later. Katia told me she would meet us outside school. Mesma coisa, não é tell, it's told. So you need to put the verb in the past. Okay? Will is going to be would. We don't need to change our verb when the report is in the present. You will have exercises to do. The teacher says we will have exercises to do. Because you say this sentence now. Okay? Let's try to do the exercises. So, just to remember again, if my report verb is in the present, I don't need to change my verb. Yes, when I'm talking about something that is a general fact, is still true or correct, I can decide if I prefer to use the sentence in the original form or if I prefer to write the sentences using the past. It's optional. Okay? The modal verbs, you are going to keep the same modal verb. In the original sentences, should. When you report, you are going to continue using should. The only one that is going to change, if the original sentence is with can, and you are going to report, you should use could. Yes? When we give the person a time allocation, we also need to change this time, this location. Okay? All right? Perfect. Exercise 1. Read the cartoon. What is misunderstanding? Where are you? You said you would meet me here at 7. No, I said I would meet you here. I mean my here. Not your here. Can you see the mistake? What is the misunderstanding? What is the mistake in this sentence? When you said, I'm going to meet you here, the person believes, yeah, or understand that is going to be in the place that he was. Okay? Lembra que eu falei? Tem que trocar o local. Tem que trocar a data. para não acontecer esses erros. Ele falou, te encontro aqui. O rapaz continuou no mesmo lugar e ele continuou no mesmo lugar. And they didn't meet each other. Okay? So he should change the place. Oh, you said you would meet me at the park at 7. In your house at 7, not here. Okay? Exercise 2. Correct the mistakes in the examples of reported speech. Some sentences have more than one mistake. So, let's start. I'm going to pop by and visit Sarah tonight. I'm going to pop by and visit Sarah tonight. I saw Joe yesterday. And she tells me that she is going to pop by and visit you tonight. So you are talking about yesterday, yes? Should I use to change my verb in this situation? If I'm talking about yesterday, eu estou reportando, contando a fofoca no mesmo dia ou um dia depois? Um dia depois. So I need to change the whole sentence. She told me that she was going. That she was going to pop by and visit you tonight. It is, é uma conversa que aconteceu ontem. So, last night. So, you should change in here. Tells. I'm going to write told. Is going to be was going. And tonight, last night. Ok? Por que, teacher? Eu só posso usar o meu report verb no presente e a minha frase no presente se a fofoca estivesse sendo contada logo após a nossa conversa, no mesmo dia. Ok? Students must leave their mobile phones in their lockers. School rules state that we had to leave our mobile phones in their lockers. We are talking about school rules is something in the present that we had or that we have. Look, my verb state is in the present. And here the verb is in the past. When I have my report verb in the present, I should have my verb in the present. We have to leave our mobile phones in their lockers, or vou guardar os nossos celulares, né? Vou guardar os nossos celulares nos armários deles ou nos nossos? In our lockers. Ok? Se o reported verb está no presente, devo mudar aqui para o presente. In our lockers. Good? I'm leaving tomorrow. In class this morning, Greta told everyone that she was leaving the day before. In class this morning, Greta told everyone she was leaving the day before. Day before é um dia antes. Mas na verdade é tomorrow, amanhã. So the mistake is here. Day before is going to be the next day. Ok? Police hope to neglected animals will be rehoused soon. On the news this morning. They said that the police hoped to neglected animals would be rehoused soon. What is the mistake that we have in this sentence? My verb here, look, my reported verb is in the past. The police said, so I need to put my sentence in the past too. Hope in the past is hoped. Yes? Okay? Again, guys, if my reported verb is in the present, my verb is going to be in the present. I need to pay attention in the time expression and change it. Okay? If my report verb is in the past, my sentence should be in the past. Here, I'm talking about something that happened yesterday, so it's in the past. I need to use my report verb in the past and the main verbs of the sentences also in the past and change the time expression. Okay? That's it, guys. Thanks for the class. I hope you understand it. It's not so hard. Okay? Thanks. Bye-bye. See you again in our video lesson tomorrow.